The pasture. On the west side of the great barn was the topography. It was steep. Further out were significant gullies indicating past washouts. And still over all, there were surface undulations from the unrecorded past. Threading through and amongst this scape were the worn paths that were cut from thousands of cloven hooves. Some trees were scattered throughout pasture area. I actually was not privileged to see the full extent of this domain and would wonder what lay beyond. I could only see the beautiful azure blue sky and the pristine white clouds floating out in a way, leaving me to wonder. Such gives one a yearning. The cows were usually safe out there. None ever got off into the gullies. Their one pass led to the grassy areas, and that is where they would go to rest, graze, sleep, and chew on their cud. They knew how to negotiate their terrain, so there was never, to my knowledge, reason for safety concerns to our herd. A pasture that is used for milk-producing cows must not be chosen frivolously. The choice must be determined on the basis of safety for the cows and especially with regards to the grazing vegetation that fill offers. The greenery must contain the necessary nutrition and provide the taste that they like. The best pasture practice is to move the cows from one area to another as the vegetation depletes and grows. I recall the drought in 1934 in Phil Campbell, Alabama, when all vegetation, excepting for the hardiest, went completely dormant or died. The things that were left were mostly bitter weeds and wild onions. Milk cannot get a worse taste than to be produced from those very hardy plants. The cows had few options, although they did not like the taste. Our cows at Mount Berry had ideal grazing conditions. Everybody loved the milk, ice cream, butter, and cheese. In hot weather, there's a deficiency of salt in the cows' diet. They, as we, need daily salt to survive. The old proverbial scripture about the devout being the salt of the earth has powerful meaning. In pastures, and more particularly in the barnyards, can be seen a white block of salt atop a short post. This is a salt lick block made accessible for cows, and bulls, if you please, to drag their corn-husking tongues across it several times. That is enough for them to attain the needed portion of salt, which has not been made available otherwise. I recall one being in our barnyard and another along the walk to the pasture.